Let's talk about the five causes of bruising. Let's say you have these little red dots or these little tiny spider veins or some red patch on your body. Let's talk about the potential causes of that, especially if you haven't injured yourself. There are different names for bruising: ecchymosis, contusions. Basically what's happening, you're getting capillary damage. Right underneath the skin, the capillaries are breaking and it's bleeding. So number one, you could be on a blood thinner, that's the obvious thing, or taking aspirin. Number two, this is not very known, low calcium. When your calcium goes too low, you get bruising. Interesting. That can come from many different things. It's usually not low calcium in the diet. It's usually from something like gastric bypass surgery, because when they do this, you become severely low in vitamin D. Without vitamin D, you can't absorb calcium. So it could be a vitamin D deficiency that's creating this low calcium. All right, calcium channel blockers, that's a medication for blood pressure. That could do it as well. Number three, low vitamin K1. Vitamin K1 helps you clot. It's a fat-soluble vitamin. So if you have malabsorption in your gut, or you have a lack of bile, let's say you don't have a gallbladder, or you have gallstones, or you have some liver problem or a kidney problem, you're not going to be able to absorb this vitamin, let alone this vitamin right here, and then that alone can create bruising. Now, antibiotics also destroy the bacteria that make vitamin K1. So vitamin K1 is very, very important, because there's something about bleeding internally that is very anti-survival. So we need to have K1. So not only does it come from leafy greens and vegetables, but it also comes from your own bacteria. So you have this backup. But if you destroy the bacteria, that could be one source of vitamin K1 deficiency. Now also vitamin C could be low. Vitamin C has everything to do about keeping your capillaries strong. So without vitamin C, you lose the collagen that surrounds the capillaries and you start having bleeding. One mild version or a subclinical vitamin C deficiency or scurvy would be bleeding gums. So the capillaries are easily damaged when you brush your teeth, and we know you're low in vitamin C. Vitamin C, sauerkraut, bell pepper, leafy greens. Pretty much the same vegetables that are loaded with K1 are also loaded with vitamin C. But of course, one cause would be, let's say you don't consume vegetables. Well, that could be why you're bruising. So we need vitamin C. Also, sugar blocks the absorption of vitamin C. Smoking inhibits vitamin C. Stress inhibits vitamin C. Taking synthetic vitamin C is something I don't really recommend. It's a cheap version of the natural vitamin C that comes from nature. I would recommend you get a food-based or a herb that is high in vitamin C, or food that is high in vitamin C versus just a synthetic vitamin C. And number five, low platelets. Another name for platelets are thrombocytes. These are things in your blood that are associated with clotting. Now, that could be a low vitamin B12 or low folate, which by the way comes from leafy greens, or you're on some medication and one of the side effects is low platelets. All right, next step, if you have bruising, is to isolate which one of these are involved and address it. Thanks for watching. Before you go, if you have a question about a product, or you're new to keto and you want to know how to begin keto, or you're on keto and you need a debug because it's not going as smooth, I have a keto consultant standing by to help you. This is just for the people in the US. Hopefully in the future, we'll be able to answer everyone's call. But I put the number down below so you can call and get some help.